Hello and welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy, and today we're going to be taking on, I think, Hari Story Galaxy and also remainder part of Battle Rock Galaxy. There was a Hungry Luma that I missed, but I'm going to have to go back and get. He wanted 30 star bits, I believe, to go into another direction. We're just going to go ahead and get into that right now by going back into the star. And we can skip all the intro. And then we're gonna take the bomb and place it here, and also go under here and collect these star bits as we can, and collect all of those. And from what I remember, I throw that one over. It didn't quite work the way I thought it would, so I'm gonna have to jump back over here. Then toss it like that. Hopefully it sits next to it close enough to blow up. Yeah, okay, it did. So little flying saucers, I actually forgot to pull this up. The little flying saucers, they kind of turn a little bit, as you can see. They're not quite completely reliable. Oh my god. Mario, do not pick that back up again. So in a Mario Party minigame, Hop a Bomb, if anybody's played that before, where you can have, like, toss the bomb back and forth. That's basically what was happening there, except I was playing catch with it instead. So I needed another couple of star bits. I believe if I go down this side, I can break that open. I'm gonna go Rainbow Mario and blow up the chain chomps. I have way more than enough, so I'm gonna talk to the Wooma. I can't talk to him when I'm Rainbow. What the heck? That's very weird. I wonder why they did that. They can't talk to him when you're Rainbow Mario. He needs 30, so we're just gonna feed him 30. Mario's like looking directly at a camera. And he becomes a planet over in that direction, and we're gonna go fly over there to it. This is one of the trash ones, isn't it? Where you have to clean up the trash in a certain amount of time. It's a minigame where you can actually die by failing to clean it up properly in time. If I can pick it up, that'd be great. I don't think that one's gonna blow up in time. I always hated these stars. I've never been very good at them in some regard, so this might take a few times. Can I just activate it again by talking to you? Yes, talk to you. Okay, you don't die, but I think Mario Galaxy 2 has one where it actually takes lives off you, the more that you fail them or something. I'm gonna try and get it back once out of the way first. I was luckily able to get that one out of the way really fast. I don't think I can blow them up really fast, can I? Nope. Nothing I can do about this one. Again. I've never been a big fan of these. Ever have I been a big fan. So, I'm gonna try this again. Hopefully those four will be detonated now. And that should blow up those back three. That should blow up those four there. This one should blow up these three. Then this one here should get blown up with those. There we go. So for his little magnet, he's gonna give us the star. We'll probably get a Prankster Comet now in this area, since there is no other one in the vicinity, and it's the last star to be done. If not, then I'll be pretty surprised. The buzzer music stays around until you actually do the buzzer level, so you won't get a standard galaxy music until you clear that up. Yeah, there's the Prankster Comet right there. The Daredevil Comet, rather. Which I guess is the boss from a certain point in the level with 1 HP, I believe. You get 1 HP, no recovery items. And it makes you do this with 1 health. But we land on this planet first, you don't need to do the whole level with 1 health, that'd be ridiculous. But we land on this little area here. I don't ever mean to like just turn like that, I always want to side flip, but I never do. Anyway, I don't think I got hit last time, so hopefully I won't get hit this time either. Then we just gotta hit him against electricity like before. Oh, careful, he doesn't hit you though. Then, like before, we just knock him into the electricity, and that should be him dead, and we're able to get the star no problem. I mean, I guess it is kind of stressful that it's on 1 HP, and you have this like, kind of like black fog overlay thing that basically tells you, hey, like it's scary and dangerous, and you should be worried about it, but it isn't that bad if you're not going to have issues fighting him. If you already know how to beat him, which all of these are designed like that, you have to know how to beat them to even get to the Prankster Star, because you have to beat them once. So we're gonna go to this planet here. And this is the one I was talking about before, where the platforms disappear underneath you as you walk along them. And the idea is that you clear off all of them to be able to proceed forward. So it lands you right here where the Goomba and the Toads are, to kind of give you an introduction to the gimmick, or mechanic, I guess, of the level. So we're going to walk around this way, and just avoid everything. You can actually skip the some of the squares by jumping on them. And like that, we can land on this platform here. So the musical notes are the things that we actually need to collect here. As you can see, so far we've been able to collect them fine, but as we're gonna go back around again, you're gonna notice that a few of them actually are on missing tails now, which makes things a little bit more difficult to do. But if you do it all correctly, everything's fine, and the planet stabilizes, and there is a star in the middle. And we just land in the middle of the planet to grab the star. It's a neat mechanic, you see a lot more of it in the later levels. It's utilized pretty well throughout the game. I'm gonna pull myself back in and go to the Bowser level now. And he's over here, so we're just gonna fly over to the reactor. And go do this level. Mm-hmm. The Bezer ones are normally more interesting than the Bezer Junior levels. And you get the Bezer Road music whenever you go into a Bezer one, which is a remix of the Mario 64 in the Dark World music, which is great for the most part. I think it's actually called Koopa Road in Mario 64 also. But I'm a big fan of this song, and I think it's like one of the most iconic songs in Mario history. There is almost nothing wrong with it, in my opinion. Oh my god, I did not know you could die like that. The more you know, I thought the Fwomp wouldn't actually be able to put you in the gravity line of dying. Also, if you get crushed by a Fwomp, it kills you instantly. So you just want to avoid that for the most part. I guess that's why, because of the gravity flips, and you kind of need to avoid it. So again, this is another gravity section where the idea is to do things in a very specific manner. To avoid landing in a black hole. Until you land up here. I'm actually gonna grab the 1-up because I lost a life, and I feel like doing that redeems me in some way, even though it doesn't at all. I got burned. So, when this thing falls, there's also the coins that you can grab here to restore your health if you took more than one hit at some point. I actually thought I was going to get burned again there. So the fire bars are a bit chaotic in this situation. There's a spore set and a normal set, or you can just take the hit if you don't want to wait on them and walk up to Bowser. Since we don't have a life stream at this point, you would get to full health by this point. Bowser also destroys the land in the area. And we have a life shroom right here. And then we have to fight him. So if I remember correctly, he generates these waves where you need to avoid him for a certain amount of time, and then he comes crashing down on the planet, and you want to make him break these little spots here to you also need to hit his tail, but he does this rotating runaway thing for a while, where he goes around in a circle, which feels erratic. It doesn't feel like he's going in a specific manner. He's gonna hurt his tail again, and then he's gonna run around here. Then he's just gonna turn. Then I'm gonna knock him over. Then I believe you jump on him or spin him again. More star bits come out of him. He does a fireball attack, and which you avoid fairly easily. Until he does the little mechanic where he makes electrifying little waves come out of him. So I'm gonna go back around this side to try and meet him, and then spin him over, and then he's gonna come back around this side again because for whatever reason he goes in the opposite direction. He does the same thing. Actually, he has homing fireballs now. Well, not homing, but like he fires one pretty quickly. If you don't get momentum fast enough, he will hit you with it. I was hoping he would actually land here, but so he's gonna go this way. Then I'm gonna knock him over and go back in this direction. Oh. And you hit him one more time. To him for the third time, which knocks him off of the planet. And then you get a grand star from him, as he is the boss of the galaxy. I'm actually really enjoying this game. I didn't think I would enjoy it quite as much as I do when jumping back into it. It's weird, like, this game kind of left a bad taste in my mouth the first time I played it. It was like, this isn't as explorative and free-brain as Sunshine and 64 are, but it's still a fun game regardless. I can understand why so many people hold it up in high regard. That activates, I believe that's the library, right? Or something. I forget what it is exactly, but... discovered a new galaxy, so... oh, it's the kitchen. I'm not gonna save the game because I'm gonna do more stuff anyway. There's that guy which you can pay Starbits to switch to Prankster Comets if you want to. There's also this guy that we can feed Starbits to make an additional level. I might as well feed him the first 400 that we're gonna give to him to make the additional level. There's also one over there next to the fountain that I have to feed later on. But he makes a little planet in the sky. Or a galaxy, I should say, that we're gonna go ahead and do soon. But first of all, we're gonna go in here into the garden again and go back into here. Or into the dome, or whatever the hell this place is called. But we're gonna fly over here to the cosmic comet in orbit. The cosmic ones, I believe, are the coin challenges. I'm just gonna go ahead and select it. Cosmic Mario race. Never mind. There's also Cosmic Mario that you have to race or whatever at some point. You have to chase him and make sure he doesn't get to the star before you. It's basically just Shadow Mario, like it was in Sunshine, but it's Cosmic now instead of Shadow, and it's not Junior. It's just, I don't know. A ghostly Mario type thing. I'm getting stuck on everything. Okay, now I need to do a save flip or something to land up here. Ground pound through here into the ground area. We get a star. I don't think there's many that are super difficult. It's just kind of annoying to move very quickly with the way that Mario's designed in this game. So that's 24. I don't want to save my game. I think that's everything in this area. That's complete. Honey Hive is not complete yet, neither is Good Egg, because there's a prankster thing to do here. But we'll go out and we'll do the Sweet Galaxy thing that was this here. I think they should have just left it as, like, a swing star. Maybe they did it so people wouldn't, you know, like, jump into it, spin, and then get stuck in a menu and be like, oh, I don't want to do this, and hit B. Basically, we're just to go through this mess of cakes and sweets to get to the star. There's a lot of, like, cookie cutter holes in the sweets and stuff that we have to avoid. There's Starbits over there, but unfortunately the camera angle changes the moment you try to get anywhere close to it. I did not mean to grab that, and I tried the long jump. I just pressed A and Z instantly. Oh, great. Okay, thankfully there's a checkpoint system, so I don't have to go through the entire thing. I almost died immediately as I came back to life. And I can get a 1-up and redeem myself. Look at that. And I believe over there. Star is right here, which is helpful, given the fact that, given the fact that we died once already, I don't really want to go through it multiple times. Now that we have this star, and I don't think any more prankster comments and stuff are going to turn up. If we do, then we'll do those before we wrap up the video. If not, then I'll go ahead and walk over to the kitchen area. So I'm gonna save the game because I believe that'll be the last star that we do right this second. Actually, there's a prankster comet in orbit right now. You're able to tell this by looking at the big screen here, like the big LCD monitor TV thing that she has. And we're able to do that by like just looking at that, taking a look, see if there's any like odd colored stars in the area. And there is one in this area, so it'll be on the Good Egg Galaxy, and it's a speedy comet. So we're gonna go over here and do this one. It's basically just another boss battle with this guy, but we need to do it in a certain amount of time. I forget the entrance way to this guy, but I think it's just gonna land us in. No, never mind. It's not gonna land us right next to him. We're gonna have to go and get to him again in 4 minutes. And once we're done here, we don't need to talk to. We don't need to talk to you, but you know, whatever. I could have just done the backflip thing like I did in the very first episode. But I guess that shows the variety of options that you have to get into the Swing Star. Don't want to get hit by the chomp, but sometimes it feels almost unavoidable when you're in Pitar. Because you don't have any momentum to move out of the way. Where is the... There it is there, but I'm going to get hit by him. Yeah, I got hit by him. There's not much I could have done to get out of the way from him. I got kind of like rolled over and pushed back along, and I thought I was going to take additional damage because of it. I was like, oh my god, please don't let me get hit a third time and die because of this stuff. I don't think I need Star Bits, I just have to kill him. Oh my god. Just die. Cutscene. And then flip my way over here into, I think we can go right over to the pipe. I don't mean to get hit, I just do somehow. Yeah, I need to kill him. So hit him, then go right up to the boss. If I recall correctly, he's one galaxy away? Maybe he's a galaxy planet away. Didn't mean to get hit by the space Goomba thing. No, we land on the boss. With 2 minutes to fight him. It takes about 30 seconds to beat him, if you do it correctly. So that's more than enough time. Where's his tail? Here we go. So he's gonna run at us, and we just spin behind him. He's gonna run at us again, and we're just gonna do the exact same thing. Yeah. confessing to that, I believe. Over a minute on the clock left. 1 minute and 41 seconds. It'll be like 1:39, maybe, by the time I get the star. 1:40. I think that may be Good Egg Galaxy done. I'm not 100% sure. I think the cosmic one, the Beehive Galaxy, or whatever it's called, Honey Hive Galaxy, has a additional star to do. And it is not actually the end of Good Egg Galaxy. I guess we're going to be coming back here at some point. Because if we go back in here, as we can see, it's not complete. Neither is this one. It does, however, have only 4 stars in it right now, whilst other ones have had 5 already, which I guess would make sense why it's not complete yet. They definitely do put more stars in them, and in traditional Mario levels, the big ones that is, they put 6 stars in them normally. Super Mario Sunshine had 6 stars, 6 episodes a level. No, it had more than that. It had 8 episodes a level and 2 additional stars, I believe. And Mario 64 had 6 episodes a level, and it had 1 additional star because of 100 coins. Anyway, we're gonna come over here into the kitchen, and we're gonna go into the next domain. So the next set of galaxies are all here, so we're gonna open them up and find out what's in them. I think we can open up a Bowser one too, but we'll do that later. So Beach Bowl Galaxy, and then there's Bubble Breeze Galaxy, which is 1 star, and then we have the Ghostly Galaxy. So we're going to take on this section in the next episode, so thank you very much for watching, and see you guys next time on Super Mario Galaxy. Yoshi.